So hey guys, welcome back to another episode. We've just left the house. It's the 16th of March today. So we're going to head down the allotment today and just quickly, I think I'm going to get those strawberries in that I took down the other day, and I'm going to take a couple of cuttings off of the blackcurrant bush, since a few of the branches have touched the ground, I noticed when I was pruning it, and they've rooted in. So we're going to take some cuttings off of those and see if we can propagate them on. So yeah, what's new? I got my banana shallot seeds come through finally yesterday, so we're going to have to plant those when I get home. And also, a big shout out to Nigel from Muddy Boots. He was our first subscriber to the channel. So huge shout out to Nigel there from Muddy Boots Allotment over on YouTube. I'll pop a link in the description if you want to go check him out. It's a really good channel. So yeah, we got about a mile and a half to walk down to the allotment now. So we'll catch back up with you when we get there. See you in a minute. So hey guys, we're down the allotment now. We just got here. I've just been having a look at our blackcurrant bushes that we said we're going to take some cuttings from. And I did forget that, I did mention it to a friend who's up in the top corner over there, that we had some low-lying branches that rooted back in, and you could take some of the cuttings if you wanted to. So I think he's actually been over and taken a couple of them, but I was just having a little look through the bushes now and I found a couple of more low-lying branches that I've rooted in, so we'll give them a go and we'll see if we can take a couple of cuttings. So I'll just turn you guys around on the camera now and we'll get to it, shall we? So here we are guys, I'll just bring you in here, and if you have a look here you can see where he's obviously pulled this one up already, but you can see how it's rooted in nicely there where it's a low-lying branch and it's just touched the floor there. There's also another one here but it hadn't rooted in properly, so I'm going to just remove that one to stop it rooting in future, so we'll just get rid of him. And there's also one more over on our back bush over there that we can hopefully take a cutting from. It's a bit more tricky than this one, but hopefully it should be okay. So what I'll do is I'll set you up over there and I'll show you how I'm going to go about doing this. Okay guys, so I've got some pots here that I've brung down, and I've also brung down some pot and compost there. So what I'm going to do is just grab one of these pots. I think, what are these? These are 2 litre pots. So I think that should do okay, should be big enough. So what I'm going to do first of all then is I'm going to have a look at this this branch and see where it would be best to cut it. So I think what we're going to do is we're going to cut him right back because we don't want him rooting back in again. So we'll cut him back there a good couple inches before the last new growth that you may be able to see here. I don't know if the camera is in the is in frame for that, but now that we've got this branch, what we'll do is we will just very gently inspect him quickly. So he's got a nice root ball on the bottom there, but it's dried out a little bit. So what I think I'm going to do is I'm going to take him over to the bath over in the corner there, and I'm going to give him a little swill to see if I can get this more of a bare rooted specimen, and then I can come back and I can have a look at this branch to see whereabouts I'm going to cut it and repot her on. I have a feeling that I may be able to get two cuttings out of this, so we'll see how it goes. So I'll be back with you just in a minute guys once I've done that. Right then guys, so we're back over here at the secondary bush that I found another low-lying branch. So I'm just gonna clean up some of this junk around it so I can get in there and inspect it a little bit better. So as you can see, I hope the camera is set up okay for you guys. But so as you can see, we've got a branch that's come out of the ground here. It's sort of re-rooted in actually right at the stem as well, but we can leave that. And it's come out of the ground and it's re-entered the ground over here right next to this raspberry cane. So what I'm going to do is got a good quality trowel here, so I'm just going to get in a good 3 to 4 inches from where it's rooted in, and I'm just going to start to gently lift the soil around it. So I'm going to try and keep as much of this root ball as I possibly can intact. without obviously getting too close to the main bush. Try not to disturb those roots. So we're getting there now. Just come in from the other side. Just get through those raspberry roots. I think I'm gonna have to lift this whole raspberry as well, which it's okay since we're getting rid of them anyway. My raspberries aren't good for sure. So we'll just come on here, hopefully miss this worm, give him a flick out the way. Back here now, I think she should be ready to pull up. Here we go, so we're under her pretty well now. We just use our trowel as a knife just to cut this layer of soil underneath. Seems like I forgot my secateurs. So I'll just go grab those quickly. Right, sorry about that, we're back. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna just cut this back a couple inches above the ground, where it comes out the first time, like so, and then I'm just gonna see to lift it as much as I can. Get my hand under here now. Break a bit of the soil away. Yeah. This goes on a lot further than I thought, actually. Comes all the way back here. So we'll stick him out as well. There we go. Now we're getting somewhere. So we have a nice root system there, so we'll leave that. I believe that's a bit of couch grass that's going in amongst it as well. But we can deal with that in a minute. We'll just cut that with our secateurs for now. It's a good route, so that we've gone, so let's lift that over there. There we go, jump him out. The hardest part is going to be separating it from this raspberry root that's here. But I think we're getting there now. Some nice deep roots underneath here. So we'll try and take those as far down as we can with our fingers. That goes very deep, so just taking a little bit more soil off the back here. I'm getting over that secateurs and give it a sniff as deep down as we can. So she's starting to come out. And I think that's it. So there we go. We have, so if you guys can see that, another good root system. We got a bit of couch grass on here, but we'll deal with that when we wash her off. So I'll leave her here for just a minute, and I'm going to come around the corner. I think there's another low-lying branch here that we need to remove. So I'll do that, and then I'll come back to you once I've washed them all off in the bath over there. Okay, guys, so we're back again. I've just washed off these and down to their bare roots in the bath next door to me. I'm not sure if the camera, you can see me in the camera, but I don't think you need to see my ugly mug anyway, to be honest, for this. So we've got three in total here. There was a few more, but like I said, I think one of our neighbours has come and had a couple, which is fine. So, yeah, this is what we've got. So this is the one that we cut out last on camera. It's got a lovely root system, as you can see on it. We have another small one, which had just started to root in, you can see here. Accidentally, it seemed to cut one of the roots off, but it's still got this very small root system, so hopefully that will come back. And finally, we have the first one that we dealt with, this long branch, which has got a nice set of roots all along the bottom here. So the first step is to start with a small one. So the first step will be to get your secateurs out, look down the length of the branch, and you're looking for basically new budding growth. And you want to also, once you're going to replant this, you want to not leave too much of the branch on. So for example, if you look at this one, we can see that we've got a nice new bit of growth here coming up. We have the root system directly below it, and then all of this over here has no roots underneath it. So what I think I'll do, since this is a very small cut-in, is we'll just clip them off of there. We'll get rid of this piece since we don't need it. I'm sure that you could actually use rooting hormone on this and get this to re-root as well, but we don't need it, so we'll just bung them out of the way. The next step then will be to get some of our compost out of our bag and fill up a couple of these pots. So I'll just do one of them quickly now just to show you. Good amount of compost in there, and then what we're going to do is we'll drill a nice big deep hole in the centre there. I can do it with one hand. There we go. And then we'll just pop this root system all the way in there. Put the branch underground as well. Just give our pot a nice tap in. Just got off a bit squiff there. Just give our pot a nice tap in. So we've just got this one main shoot still coming out of the ground, and we'll pop it to one side. So I'll just quickly show you this one here. This is another interesting one. Since we have a lot of root system across the bottom here, we can actually get more than one cutting out of this. So I'll just show you quickly how I'll go about doing that. So first job is obviously to come down and inspect the branch for any new signs of growth, like we have some small buds here, some here, and obviously this new shoot here. So what I'll do is I'll just look down this branch. I think we can probably get one off the end here. We can get one off the middle here. And let's see that we can get chop this one up into three. I think three will be adequate here. So we'll just first of all pop it down, and we'll cut in there and get rid of this one piece. So we've got a nice bud here with some roots underneath it that we can then hopefully cut off around here. So we'll just make a nice little gap over the roots. So we'll cut any of them. So there's one. You see the bud here, so he will go that way down. So come off to one side. If we have another look again, we can see that we have this nice bit of rootstock here. So I think we'll take him off in one. There. So we've got this nice one here. We've got some new buds down the bottom, and we've got this ready main shoot. So we'll pop them off to one side. And then finally, down here, we can see that we have a new bud that's grown here. Plenty of rootstock along here to support it. We haven't really got anything at this end of the branch, so what I think I'll do is I will... How do I want to go about this? So I can either knock this bud off and keep this main stem, or I can cut it around here and leave the grow back from there. In this case, looking at this main branch, it looks still pretty healthy. So I think what I'll do is I'll just leave that bud there. And for now, we'll just cut them off above there. And I think that will be our third one there. So, for from that one, we are now left with three that we can repot on. So I'll get on, I'll repot these on along with this one, put them in down and repot them on. Quickly before I do that and go, one thing I will say about this one is you cannot see any new growth on it, because obviously it was only this little piece that was out of the ground. So what I'm going to do is I'll plant him this way up, I'll cut him off around here, and hopefully it will back bud somewhere down the bottom here for us. So I'll get on and I'll do these, and we'll check in once I finish, guys. Hey guys, we're back again. So I've just finished potting these on now. As you can see down here, they've potted on quite nicely. This was the one that didn't have any buds sticking out the top of it, so we're not sure what's going to happen there. But it did have the best set of roots on of the lot of them, so we leave him and we see what happens. This one has a little bud sticking out here, and we obviously have this nice tall one, which usually I would cut back to one or two significant buds, but in this case, since it has already has quite a big rootstock and we're not actually using rooting hormone, I think it should be okay just to leave as it is. And finally the fifth one there, which is potting on nicely. So what we're going to do with these now, guys, is we're going to take them home and I'm going to put them in my cold frame in my garden on top of a couple of layers of wet carpet. That way that'll keep the humidity up inside that cold frame and stop these drying out. So hopefully then by the middle of the summer we should start to see some new growth on these, and they can be potted on for next year then. So brilliant. So all I'm going to do now is I'm going to go over back to the bushes, and I'm just going to clear out any low-lying branches that are touching the ground but haven't rooted in yet. So we'll do that, and then we'll get on with planting our strawberries. Okay guys, so we're back over here on our strawberry bed. As you can see, we've got some lovely runners that I brought down from the house. They all propagated last year off of just these two trays here. We got one over there and one here. They had, I think, four plants in each, some that I was given by a friend, and they then propagated to fill that nice big long black tray there, and some that were over the side that rooted into my sandbox that I just put on top of there for the time being. So we're back over here now. So we're going to plant into, not this tun bag because we've already got some in there, but right next door to this tun bag, we're going to fill this bed up, hopefully, up until these bushes over here. So the first step in what we're going to do is we're going to pick up our trusty rake here, and we're just going to level out this manure bed. So how I go about doing this is just tamping it down gently as we go along. It's pretty difficult to do with one hand, but we do that just to get the manure down to ground level, nice and flat, so it ends up looking more like this bed over here then. So I'll just get on with that, and then I'll get back to you guys. Alright guys, so there's our bed all tamped down nice now, so there's no longer any lumps like this bed over here. It's gone nice and flat now, so that's ready now to be planted into. So since this video is getting a bit long anyway, I'll just quickly show you how I'm going to go about doing this. It's pretty much the same as how I will go about planting everything this year in this bed, or in this allotment, should I say, on these manure beds. So how I go about doing it is I just find a place where I want to plant. So let's say here, for example. Is that on camera? Yeah, there we go. So all I'll do is I will just get my trowel in there, put it in both ways, and just leave it back and forth slightly, and that gives us a nice hole then. So if you guys can see that properly, but it gives us a nice hole straight through the manure into the soil below. So then what I do is I make sure then all that root system gets down below this manure into the soil, and then the manure can then act like a mulch. But one thing I will say about strawberries, guys, in case you don't know, is when you actually go to plant them, let's have a look if we've got one here. It's a bit of a dead one that didn't quite come on, but if you have a look here, guys, you can see that you have the crown of the strawberry. Make sure that you don't plant any lower than that crown, because obviously the strawberry will rot otherwise. Just make sure that root system is down in the ground below the manure, but the crown itself is above. So what I'll do, guys, is I'll just get on, do this bed now, I tell you what, I'll set up the camera over here and I'll just leave a recording, and we'll see if we can do a little bit of a time lapse for you. But this video, unfortunately, is getting a bit on the long side now, so I'll see when I get back in the house to edit it. So I'll set you up over there, guys, and I'll leave a record now, see how much memory I got left on this phone, and we'll get back with you shortly. Okay guys, so we're back up the house now. Sun's starting to go down and it's starting to get a bit chilly, so I thought I'd come back home. I brought home these cuttings that we've done today, and I've put them inside of the coal frame. I've also put a piece of carpet underneath the coal frame and really soaked that in to keep the humidity up inside of here. And I'll make sure I keep all of these cuttings damp now. So hopefully by the summer we should start to see some new growth on these, and I can hopefully plant them on next year then. So I'll just put this lid back down to keep the moisture level up in there. One thing I didn't mention to you guys last time when we were doing the tour was these willow trees. I just wanted to quickly mention that when I was back in November, this was now, I was walking past, I think it was this one here, as you can see there, and I snapped one of the branches off by accident. So all I did then was I decided just to throw it in this bucket of compost pot full of water there with no holes in the bottom, rainwater. And if you look closely enough, you can see that it's already started to re-root on, and we've got some more spots there where some roots are going to come through shortly. So I'm just going to leave it in this water for the next couple of months, and hopefully by summertime I can repot that on and it should grow into another willow tree. So finally guys, before we sign off, I was just going to show you all my compost trays that I filled up there. It's that time of year now, ready to start seed sowing, so I'll probably take those in the house later and start to sow all of them up. I just filled them up last night before I went to bed. One last thing guys, as well, obviously the camera did run out of memory when we were down the allotment planting all the strawberries in, so sorry about that, but I think this video's got long enough now anyway. So with all that said and done, I guess I'll sign off for today, and we'll catch you guys next time. So until then, I'll see you then guys.